I'm your host, Paul Jones, and today I've got a very talented wideout from Fullerton College, Mr. Juice County, Marquis Avery. Thank you for joining me today, sir.
Appreciate you having me.
Absolutely. So, you know, we got to get into it, the JC lifestyle, and then my man moving on to, as you see, San Jose State. That's how we do it at the JC Profile. Guys, get up and get out. So I got to start off by asking you, 6'4", 180 coming out of Savannah High School, no offers on the table. What made you go to Fullerton?
Probably it was just because it was close. You know what I mean? At first, I tried to go to Mount Sac, but my car situation at the time wasn't as it should have been, so just might as well go to Fullerton. It's right close. And plus, they recruited me out of high school, so
there you go.
Fit perfect.
Blessing in disguise. Now, at the time, you know, some might be skeptical of going to Fullerton because it was all run.
Oh yeah, when I got there as a freshman, we had this running back, Joseph Chapman, probably one of the rawest running backs I've ever seen, period.
Yes.
And yeah, that was their job, hand him the ball and he would get off. But I don't know, I just wanted to try it out, you know what I mean? Because I think I had the ability to maybe change a few things there.
And as we see, a few things did change. You got a new offensive coordinator, and you guys went pass heavy. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, what we did is, my freshman year when I got there, we also got a big-time prospect out of Ray P, came from Valencia High School. We also had a few other receivers there. Rashad Chambers was there at the time. You was there, actually, my freshman year. So we had a few people, so... Our new offensive coordinator decided to change it up maybe to a 4-wide-1 back set because we didn't really have a fullback at the time and just wanted to get, basically put the ball in the playmaker's hand.
Okay, yeah. Playmaker, number one, right here. Now you set a little record over at Fullerton College with 15 receptions in a game. That, let you guys know, that record was there for 14 years. So tell me a little bit about that.
Oh man, that whole game was crazy. It was just probably one of the most intense games I've ever been in. We was down by 3 touchdowns in the fourth quarter. And I think I caught about, I want to say 8 passes, 8 out of the 15 in the fourth quarter. And then 3 of my touchdowns came in the fourth quarter. And I guess with the help of the defense and everybody else, I helped us get a victory. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I guess so. 8 catches in the second half.
Yeah.
3 touchdowns. Yeah, that's real nice.
Yeah, it was a very intense game. It was away at College of the Canyons too. And everybody knows College of the Canyons is year in, year out one of the best JC programs in the country.
That's right. College of the Canyons. So these guys came back down 3. 3 touchdowns. Come back. College of the Canyons, we give them props.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget about the Hornets. So tell me about the difference of your first season playing at Fullerton to the second season and your production.
Oh, man. My first season, I guess you could say I was kind of nervous because it was technically my first collegiate football season.
Right.
Of course. So there was kind of like little things I needed to fix, like my fundamental route running. It wasn't on point. I was kind of sloppy. I will admit that my freshman year I was very lazy.
Okay.
Said when it came to run plays, I took a lot of the run plays off.
Right.
And it was basically just getting used to the format of the offense and the whole offensive scheme because it was a whole new scheme and something I wasn't used to.
Right.
Coming from high school to JC, it was a whole new advanced one playbook.
Right. Now, what I will say is I like how you pointed that out, how you took plays off and you were lazy. Now, when I'm on scout.com, they're saying that this guy is one of the best college blockers at wideout. So you see the coaching and the production level and the maturity of this guy to go from his freshman season, taking plays off, kind of lazy on it, And now, with at the scout level, you know, it says that this guy is a blocker. So I mean, that shows a lot of maturity. So tell me the growth from your freshman year to your sophomore season.
Oh, it was a tremendous growth, because basically I knew I wanted to go play Division I football. Freshman year, that really wasn't in my mind because I had other receivers in front of me that were doing a lot more production and getting a lot more attention than I was. So it really wasn't on my mind. But as soon as my sophomore off season came, I realized the potential that I really had and really realized what, you know what I'm saying, what was in store for me and what I had ahead of me. So it's just, I had to basically get my priorities straight. Just in the weight room, went that extra mile when everybody was gone. I was usually come back in after practice and probably get a few more because I'm a little skinny, as you can see. So I had to do whatever I could to basically keep myself uninjured. When it came to the field, just the little stuff, like basically after the catch, making sure you score every time. And that's something Coach Roskelly, who was my receiver coach at Fullerton College, I love that man.
Me too.
Coach Roskelly, he basically said, every time you touch the ball, you gotta score. You gotta score. And that's how I took it, because in the game, that's what it is.
Right.
Every time you touch the ball, you wanna score.
Right.
So it was just little stuff, you know what I'm saying? Fixing the fundamentals, actually focusing more on my route running, like the little stuff, running the arms when you break it. I mean,
right.
Moving the arms when you break down, little stuff. And basically just the growth that happened was I just got smarter. That's all it was. It's, as my age grew older, my brain got bigger too.
There you go. I like that. So now you said you had to get your priorities straight.
Mm-hmm.
Now, me also being at the JC level and seeing a lot of guys, they don't have that priority straight. So what advice would you give guys who are looking at you and trying to get where you are?
First, number one thing is, school is first.
Right.
You gotta take care of school, because if you don't take care of your school, the athletic ability means nothing.
Absolutely.
And that's something I had to learn the hard way.
Right.
So, basically, and then always, never doubt yourself. Mm-hmm. Because only you can progress yourself. Can't nobody else push you forward but yourself.
Right. So tell me, now you're going up to the D1 level.
Mm-hmm.
You're going up to San Jose State. But in that in-between time when you finished your last season at Fullerton, there was a lot of schools recruiting you.
Yes.
Now tell me a little bit about those schools.
But I was getting recruited by West Virginia, Kentucky. Got a few letters from LSU. Never really got a call from them, but you know what I'm saying? It's always exciting to see a letter come from a school like that. Got recruited by Arizona State. Utah was really recruiting kind of heavy. And basically, yeah, San Jose State was there from the beginning too. And I noticed that. I didn't let that go by, because as time went on, like I said, school, you gotta take care of that first, and that's something nobody told me at the time.
Mm-hmm.
No, nobody at Fullerton College told us really that we need to take care of school. I mean, they told us, but they never were really on our heads about it.
Right.
So I kind of slacked a little bit in that, and it showed in my transcripts.
Mm-hmm.
So when the coaches would come in and say, hey, well, can we see his transcripts? They would see it, and they would see a lot of W's, which means withdrawals after the deadline to withdraw a date from a class. And that's, as any junior college student knows, a W is not good. It seems like I had all this attention, and then everybody else fell off but one.
Right.
And no matter what, and it was funny too, because after the summer or semester of school, Purdue came along and was like, well, we want to offer you a scholarship. And I kind of looked at it with like, nah, I'm good, I'm going to San Jose. Even though Purdue's in the Big Ten playing against Michigan, Ohio State,
right.
Michigan State, that would have been lovely. But, you know what I mean, I think loyalty is the number one thing.
That's awesome. So this guy had a chance, he could have gone to Purdue, but San Jose State was there from the beginning. It's loyalty, interchangeable, they showed loyalty, he showed loyalty back. Now San Jose State is about to get a big time receiver, Mawson Katz in the end zone. As you can see with Marquis Avery, all you gotta do is apply yourself and make it happen. Like he said, do work. Don't follow your dreams, chase them, cause the only person who can stop you is you. And this is living proof of it right here. Paul Jones, Marquis Avery, the JC Profile.